her bishop to establish the religious congregation now known as the Sisters of Providence. By the time she was 24 years old, she had lost her husband and her three children. She then spent 20 years caring for indigent elderly women. Her work was greatly appreciated, and her bishop wanted to honor it by turning it over to the Daughters of Charity from France as a way to stabilize it. And I'm not sure that today's women would appreciate that way of honoring your work. In any case, the sisters did not come. So the bishop established his own community of sisters, and Emily joined it. In 1856, just 13 years later, some of the sisters accepted the invitation to come to Vancouver, Washington, in the Pacific Northwest. Then, in 1864, they came to Montana. Mother Mary of the Infant Jesus and her companions were the first women of European ancestry to cross Lolo Pass. And they did it on horseback, riding side saddle. They came at the request of the local tribes who wanted the sisters to teach their daughters. Now, they knew about the sisters because members of the Iroquois tribes in New York State had told them about the Black Robes, the Jesuits, and the sisters. So they came to teach the local tribes. In 1932, it was considered time to make Catholic higher education available to Montana by founding the Normal School, which was a school for the education of teachers. That became the College of Great Falls, today the University of Providence, and now available to both men and women. I'd like to tell you another story. It's a different story. In the 1940s, Emperor Hirohito of Japan supported his army's plan to conquer the Pacific. The bombing of Pearl Harbor led to a young Irish-American student from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to be stationed in Boise, Idaho. He often said that the only thing that he knew about Idaho was that it was a state and it had a capital. There he met and married a granddaughter of Oregon Trail pioneers, and I am that daughter. That's my family story, showing how the decisions of those that came before and distant from us affect all of our history. And you too can tell such stories about how we got here today. But it goes further than that. Your actions today and tomorrow will affect the whole world for good and for ill. Our stories illustrate a crucial point. We stand at a flashpoint of history, which, with countless decision points that express the extreme promise of our world. And at the same time, we know that many of those decisions will be less than honorable, even evil, and that they can cast long shadows affecting generations to come. We already see this in the human condition in which we live and in the decisions around us being made every day. Yet, we can afford to hope. We see great evil and we see heroic good, and we call that providence. The mysterious action of God that honors our freedom to choose good and evil, but which is always nudging us to the good. And so, in a few minutes, you graduates will receive your diplomas. We will watch you with pride as representatives of all those who have gone before you and have prepared your way. We will watch and we will cry, knowing that all the universe is present in this moment. Then we will let you go, taking our strands of history with you into the future. We know it as a sacred trust. We will let you go to set sail through the future, believing that you will take what has been given to you and that you will pass it forward to others, and so that together we can work to bring about God's hopes and aspirations, that we can all be agents of providence. O providence most gentle, O providence most kind, all praise and all thanksgiving be forever thine.
The Distinguished Alumni Award is awarded to, typically, an individual who has distinguished her or himself through personal and professional successes and civic contributions while bringing a sense of pride and recognition to the university community. Since 1996, our university has been presenting this award to the most prestigious graduates for their professional achievements, contributions to society, and support of their alma mater. Since their establishment as a congregation of Catholic women religious in 1843, the Sisters of Providence have dedicated themselves to the care of the poor and vulnerable wherever they went to establish ministries in education, healthcare, and social services. One such ministry is, of course, the University of Providence. Over the course of our 90-year history, the University of Providence has had the honor of educating countless Sisters of Providence in their pursuit of continuing education credits, completing certificates, and of course, in obtaining baccalaureate and graduate degrees. A total of 172 Sisters of Providence have earned their degrees from this university since our founding in 1932. And have gone on to serve Providence ministries as administrators, healthcare professionals, missionaries, the foundresses of other ministries, authors, artists, provincial superiors, provincial counselors, and of course, as teachers. Today, we honor these Sisters of Providence alumnae of our own University of Providence and express our heartfelt gratitude for their years of devotion to the people of God. In the coming weeks, our living alumnae will receive tangible tokens of our appreciation in the form of their Distinguished Alumni Awards. For those alumnae who have already gone home to God, a series of masses will be offered throughout the year in thanksgiving for their lives of service. It is now my privilege to present this particular token of our appreciation to Sister Barbara Schamber, the provincial leader of the Sisters of Providence, Mother Joseph Province, who herself, like me, graduated from a Providence school founded by a UP sister alumna. Sister Barbara?
Thank you so much. What a great honor for the Sisters of Providence to receive this award from our University of Providence. Today, another member of our leadership team, Sister Jacqueline Fernandez, joins me here, as well as the first mission vice president for mission, Sister Mary Hawkins. So there are four Sisters of Providence here with you today, and many more throughout our province. In the booklet is listed all the Sisters of Providence who are in heaven, but there's a special section up below of all those who are living. And you'll see the name of Sister Cecilia Paganesi in the list of those living. She turns 102 years old, and she is as active and alert as ever. So there's great hope for longevity, graduates. Congratulations.
That's a hard act to follow. Thank you. I have the distinct pleasure of introducing this year's Outstanding Leadership Award. Let me start by saying thank you. Thank you for choosing the University of Providence. Thank you for sticking with us. The last 2.5 years have not been easy for you. You'll be able to tell your grandkids stories of how you survived the global pandemic. Just so you know, the story doesn't outdo the story your parents told you about having to walk to school in 6 feet of snow both ways uphill with just leather straps on their feet. So just remember that. The Outstanding Leadership Award is given each year to a graduating senior in recognition of their contribution to our campus culture as a leader. Eligible students are nominated by the staff and faculty of the university. Finalists apply and are considered by a committee of delegates from across the campus. Only one is chosen to receive the award. Would the following people please stand? Levi Anderson. Oh, you can stand. J.F. Daho. Jenna Everts. Dawson Fowler. Gudmundur Gumi Gudmundsson. Cole Koenig. Sarah Terram. This year's recipient of the Outstanding Leadership Award is Cole Koenig. Cole spent 4 years on our men's soccer team. He worked as a resident assistant trying to keep you all in line. He was a volunteer for our Providence Formation Program, was elected Secretary of Student Government for 2 years, worked as an academic program assistant, helped ignite excitement for our esports club, and acted as a peer mentor. There are many other areas where I could highlight Cole's influence on campus. Cole's dedication to academics and the University of Providence helped to set a great example for numerous students who witnessed his work ethic. He and the other nominees for this award have made me a better person and the University of Providence a better place. Let's now hear from Cole.
Thank you. Thank Hello, everyone, and thank you for attending the 2022 University of Providence graduation ceremony. My name is Cole Koenig, and I'm graduating with a degree in business administration with a finance concentration. Throughout these past 4 years, I've been blessed with the opportunity to be on the men's soccer team, a member of student government, a resident assistant, a peer mentor, and a student worker. So I guess the only thing I did not do here is get any sleep. I'm beyond grateful for the time that I have spent participating in all these extracurriculars, not only as a resume builder, but as a character builder. With all of the changes that occurred over the last couple of years, the university had to do a lot of adapting to try and continue on a path of success. And through that, I was guided by many strong and influential leaders and mentors that have challenged me and helped me develop as an individual. As my business professor, Katrina Stark, has reminded me, you are who you are not solely based on what you have done, but because of what others have done for you. In light of that, I would like to extend a wholehearted thank you to my parents, my family, my professors, my friends, my coaches, and the multiple different bosses/supervisors I've had throughout my time here at UProvidence. I would not be in this position had you not spent time investing in me and pushing me to do better. The man you are looking at right now is the fruit of your hard labor, and I will never be able to repay you fully. So to conclude, to my fellow 2022 graduates, I would just like to remind you to always keep in mind those who helped you get here right now, and never forget to let them know how grateful you are. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg, and congratulations, Cole. Will the candidates for the degree Associate of Science and Bachelor of Science in all respective curricula please stand and come forward to receive your degree?
Viridiana Juarez, Bachelor of Science, Healthcare Administration, cum laude. Cameron Elizabeth Davies, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Courtney Ann Davies, Bachelor of Science, Nursing, cum laude. Linda Luz Jackson, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Cheryl Keel, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Olivia Lynn Tuttle, Bachelor of Science, Nursing, cum laude. Levi Gordon Anderson, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, cum laude. J.F. Dahomanzo, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Dawson Albert Fowler, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, cum laude. Lana Hunt, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Kyler W. Mack, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Isabel Jalissa Martineau, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, magna cum laude. Stephen Andrade Moreno, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Mark Gregory Nazareno, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Jake Glenn Olson, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, summa cum laude. Kimberly K. Simoneau, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, summa cum laude, Outstanding Achievement by a Student in Exercise Science. Jensen Turner, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science. Matthew Wilkinson, Bachelor of Science, Exercise Science, cum laude. Christian Kealakaa Kabanila Balagaso, Bachelor of Science, Accounting, magna cum laude. Gudmundur Oskar Gudmundsson, Bachelor of Science, Accounting, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in accounting. Sarah Worrell, Bachelor of Science, Accounting, summa cum laude. George Almeida, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, cum laude. Jesus Daniel Arellano, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Alan Joseph Badley, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Luke Daniel Bleskin, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Rashid Alexander Butler, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jaden Marie Duncan, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jacob Christopher Fry, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Manuel Garcia, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Emma Lee Goodwin, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, magna cum laude. Jackson John Robert Hashley, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Benjamin James Call, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, cum laude. Cole Lawrence Koenig, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in business administration. Kylie Nicole Manning, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration, summa cum laude. Logan D. Steeney, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Colton Ray Stodgehill, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jess Albert LeMaster Jr., Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in computer science. Joshua Radam Samana, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Brady Curtis Dahl, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, magna cum laude. Elizabeth M. Basu, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies. Jean-Denis Marcel Albert Ducimetier, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, summa cum laude. Lakia Joyce Jackson, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, Army National Guard. Mitchell Robert Lucas, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, United States Air Force. Norman Harlan Mininger Jr., Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, magna cum laude, United States Army. Erica Elaine Reisner, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, summa cum laude, United States Army National Guard. McKenna Ann Montgomery, Bachelor of Science, Forensic Science, outstanding achievement by a student in Forensic Science. Madison May Naparella, Bachelor of Science, Forensic Science, Biology Track, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in Forensic Science, Biology Track. Demaray Allen Conley, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, United States Air Force. David Paul DeYoung, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, summa cum laude, United States Navy. Ruben Christopher Graf, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, summa cum laude. Christine Marquez Lara, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Jillian Paula Sanchez, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice. Jaden Renee Stiebritz, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, Bachelor of Science, Legal and Paralegal Studies, cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in criminal justice. Bo Curtis Vasky, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, cum laude. Caden John Woodarski, Bachelor of Science, Criminal Justice, cum laude.
Will the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Arts in all respective curricula please stand and come forward and receive your degree?
Christian Victor Anders Aquinas Brink, Bachelor of Arts, Theology and Ministry. Olivia Lynn Atley, Bachelor of Arts, Biology. Kaylee Ann Beer, Bachelor of Arts, Biology. Leo Thomas Zumerchik Felt, Bachelor of Arts, Biology, magna cum laude. Dylan Joseph Gilbert, Bachelor of Arts, Biology. Madeline Nicole Griesmer, Bachelor of Arts, Biology, cum laude. Gabriel Jason Kwiatkowski, Bachelor of Arts, Biology, cum laude. Outstanding achievement by a student in biology. Joshua Michael Pepis, Bachelor of Arts, Biology, magna cum laude. Sarah Eiley Tarum, Bachelor of Arts, Biology, summa cum laude. Marky Alexandria Thompson, Bachelor of Arts, Biology. Marka Ann Heron, Bachelor of Arts, Elementary Education, cum laude. Taylor Nicole Matthews, Bachelor of Arts, Elementary Education, magna cum laude. Ashley Lillian Marie Seibel, Bachelor of Arts, Elementary Education, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in elementary education. Shelby Louise McMillan, Bachelor of Arts, Secondary Education, Bachelor of Arts, Broadfield Social Science, Bachelor of Arts, History, summa cum laude. Jenna Marie Everts, Bachelor of Arts, Special Education, Bachelor of Arts, Elementary Education. Cameron Grace Cady, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Matthew Ian Dollar, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology, Bachelor of Arts, Addictions Counseling, magna cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in addictions counseling. Reed Aaron Hazard, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Samantha Marie Hernandez, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Alicia M. Otis, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Cyrena Rosales, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Evan Scholes, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Emil Hayden Schroll, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Mackenzie Marie Stotts, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jaden Williams, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Sandy Josette Coos Moore, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology, summa cum laude, outstanding achievement by a student in sociology. Brianna May Suazo, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology, Air National Guard.
Will the candidates for all master's degrees in all respective curricula please stand and come forward to receive your degree.
Rosalyn Tapneo Osina, Master of Healthcare Administration. Catherine Tuan Din, Master of Healthcare Administration with distinction. Christine Elizabeth Foster, Master of Healthcare Administration. Daniel Hernandez, Master of Healthcare Administration, with distinction. Rebecca Jane Mayer, Master of Healthcare Administration. Tara Nicole Wagner Yoshiwara, Master of Healthcare Administration. Shannon James Auger, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling. Kimberly Marie Brainerd, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling with distinction. Jordan Robert Clarfield, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling. Tyra Jane Contini, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling, United States Army. Wow. Ruxandra Fee, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling, with distinction. Dawn Marie Moles, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling. Marilee Michelle Norvell, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling, outstanding achievement by a student in Master of Science, Clinical Mental Health Counseling. Alida Marie Troxel, Master of Science in Clinical Mental Health Counseling, with distinction. Rebecca Betts, Master of Science in Infection Prevention and Epidemiology, with distinction. Morgan Osbrook Giddings, Master of Science in Infection Prevention and Epidemiology. Jeanette McLaren, Master of Science in Infection Prevention and Epidemiology. Shelley Boss, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator, with distinction. Melanie Dickinson, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator, with distinction. Sheila Norris Gallagher, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Angela Sampson Gadula, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Badani Lemi Galeta, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Timothy McLean Lochran, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator, with distinction. Lizette Morales Revels, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Shalini Rajni Stubbs, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator, with distinction. Kathleen Ray Tubridi, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Rebecca Ann Welch, Master of Science, Nursing, Nurse Educator. Rosa Lee Hammond, Master of Science in Accounting, outstanding achievement by a student in Master of Science Accounting, U.S. Navy. Michelle Lynn Ball, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership, with distinction. Kennedy Rose Cartwright, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership, with distinction. Kaden Rain Diefenbach, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership. Terrell Andrea Banks Jr., Master of Science in Sports Management, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership. Parker Ray Esri, Master of Science in Sports Management, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership. Mackenzie Mae Tippett Gast, Master of Science in Sports Management. Caitlin Michelle Marsick, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership, Criminal Justice, with distinction.
We're next. No. So I'm going to introduce you. I'll call you.
Will all the graduating students please stand? Father Doyle, after examination of their respective academic records and following the approval of the faculty and the Board of Trustees, I recommend these candidates for their degrees.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the University of Providence, pending completion of all academic requirements, I hereby confer upon you the degree for which you have been nominated with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto. I invite those graduates receiving undergraduate degrees today to signify your graduate status by performing the symbolic act of moving your tassel from the right to the left side of your mortarboard. Will the entire audience please stand as you are able and join the graduating class of 2022 in the singing of the Alma Mater and remain standing throughout the recession. Who's singing it? Do we have somebody to sing it?
Where the prairie's golden glory spreads beneath the matchless sky, and the sparkling waters falling toss their rainbow mist on high, stands a citadel of learning, guarding knowledge, truth, and right. From its watchtower ever beaming, golden pathways through the night. Ave, ave, Alma Mater, voices ringing out with might, sing the glory of your story, of your love for truth and light.
Congratulations to you all, graduates and families and friends. Graduates, it is time to bid you farewell. I know you're saying it's about time. We wish you well in the many varied paths your lives will take you, and we hope that you will tell us of your journey along the way. Graduates, guests, faculty, and staff, please join us for the bell ringing and the alumni reception located in the main entrance of the University Center building.
In silence first, we pray. Gracious and caring God, our source of light, we ask for your almighty hand to be upon these graduates as we send them forward. With their classes and grading now complete, may they strive toward excellence in all they do. With the applause quieted, may they celebrate and lift up those around them. With the speeches concluded, may their voices rise up to pronounce peace and justice in the world. With the fanfare ceasing, may they find bliss in future endeavors and adventures. With advanced degrees and credentials in hand, may their achievements grow and enrich their communities. As Jesus taught, may they discover holiness in the midst of life's blessings as well as life's challenges. And as your career commence, may you conduct your life's work with exceptional skill and integrity, inspired to go forth and set the world afire for this day onward. And this prayer we offer through Jesus, who is our risen Lord, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
I think a logo is important. It sort of, you know, it marks us.
One, two, three.